sketching trig functions using radians. For each one of these, we're going to collect this information, and the question is given in this format. So let's take a look at our next example. Y equals this sinusoidal function. Now by looking at this, immediately let's collect our data here. Well, what is our base function? Well, our base function will be y equals sine x. So let's sketch that here. Let's do a rough sketch. You guys should know this by heart. Positive 1, negative 1. You start at 0. You go at the top, then you go down, then you go all the way there. And it takes 2 pi to complete one cycle. Halfway will be pi. Halfway between these will be pi over 2. And this would be 3 pi over 2. Okay, you probably don't need to label all of them, but at least we have that as a reference. And by the way, that's 0. Okay, now let's collect all the other data. So the amplitude is 1 over 2 or 0.5. I'm just going to write 0.5 for now. Okay, is there a k value? Well, what's the k value? Okay, let's forget about the k value for now. Let's look at the equation of axes. Well, what's the equation of axes on this one? Well, it's not shifting up or down. That means that the equation of axes will be 0. So y equals 0. Then we need to look at the d value. There's a shift to the left by pi over 4. So that means negative. So d is equal to negative pi over 4. All right. And now let's take a look at this. Now, remember, the formula for the period is equal to 2 pi over k. In this case, k happens to be 1, so 2 pi over 1 gives us 2 pi. So that should be actually quite straightforward and easy to do this one, to graph this one. What is our maximum value? Maximum value would be c plus a. So c is 0 plus a is 0.5. So the maximum value is 0.5, and the minimum value is negative 0.5, right? This minus that. And now we've got everything. We've got the base function, so let's sketch this. Now, we're going to sketch this starting there. All right. So, I'm going to graph this. And that's our negative pi over 4. Hopefully, I can fit that on the screen. I think so. Yeah, and then we draw the equation of axes, which in this case happens to be 0, y equals 0, so we can do actually a solid line here. Y equals 0, and actually we can in fact label that as y equals 0, but we can do that later. The maximum value, oh, it's 0.5, and the minimum value will be negative 0.5. Okay, and it takes 2 pi to complete one cycle. And so, and we're going to start at the equation of axes, and then we go up, and then we go up and down, and then up again. So somewhere around there. So that means negative pi over 4 plus 2 pi. Okay, so what happens when we complete 2 pi here? So one way of figuring this out is basically by doing this, in case you're wondering, right? Well, I guess different ways. Let me see if we can figure it out too by making a rough sketch of the unit circle, right? If we start there and we do 2 pi, we're gonna end up at, let me take a wild guess, I think we're going to end up at this part, 3 pi over 2 plus pi over 4. That gives us, what, this would be 6 pi plus pi, that's 7 pi over 4, 7 pi over 4. Okay, I think we can also figure it out this way. Let's see, negative 5, negative pi over 4, plus 2 pi. Okay, I'm kind of digressing here, but I think it works out the same way too. Negative pi plus 8 pi. That's right, 7 pi over 4. So either way it works. You guys probably noticed what I did here, right? I added 3 pi over, look, if you start here at negative pi over 4 and you go around 2 pi, you end up there. You could also figure this out by doing 3 pi over 4, 3 pi over 2 plus pi over 4, right? That gives you 7 pi over 4. Or you could also do it this way. Negative pi over 4, which is here, add the period to it, which is 2 pi, and this is what we did. This is probably the most straightforward way. Okay. Anyways, if you're not sure, just you can pause the video, go back, or choose any of those two calculation methods. So this would be our 7 pi over 4. Okay, so this is our 7 pi over 4. So then you divide this in four parts. Halfway there, halfway there, and halfway there. Now, halfway between these two, it would be here, right? So look at this. If you start there and go around, right? Now, halfway between these two would be this point here, which we figure out on our previous example that this turned out to be 3 pi over 4. So that's halfway there is 3 pi over 4. So this is our 3 pi over 4, right? Now, halfway between these two points will be there over here, if you guys can see that. So halfway between these two points, it will be that. And we know that that one is pi over 4, so this will be pi over 4, and it makes sense, right? You have 45, minus 45, all the way to pi over, to 40, sorry, minus pi over 4, all the way to positive pi over 4, you have a total of pi over 2. Or if you want to look at it in degrees as well, minus 45, the difference between minus 45 degrees and 45 gives you 90. Okay, anyways, and 3/4 of the way would be this one over here, which we figure out that it turned out to be 5 pi over 4. So this will be 5 pi over 4. All right. And I think we've got everything. So now we know it's the sine function. It starts here. It goes all the way to the top. Goes back to the equation of axis. Hits the minimum. And then it goes back into the axis. Now join these with a smooth curve. Okay, so there you go. Oh no. Something like that. It was a little shabby here. There you go. And that's our equation. Now, this is our sketch for this equation right here. Okay. Let's take a look at a few more examples.